Your birth was considered a taboo. Each step you took since was subject to review. The only valid reason to open your mouth was to satisfy the needs of men. Human rights were wrong for you. Hell, you needed approval to even pick up a pen. At times your lights are turned off even before you enter the world. The atrocities you're put through can make even the bravest of men cold. The darkest of men want to marry the brightest of you. But brightness isn't linked to the mind here. It means how your skin glows. Everyone wants a son to carry the family name through. Not one person thinks that if there aren't any of you left, there's no way it will grow. Oh, and you should be a virgin too. Sex is only a luxury afforded to the male species. I wonder who they have it with though, since homosexuality isn't considered very peachy. You should save yourself for after the vows, while we go about spraying our semen every time we feel aroused. It's not only the men that hold you back. Sometimes it's your own that give you the most awful slack. Do something about your weight, work out, not like you have the best rack. Focusing on your career is detrimental to your marriageability. You're subject to various superstitions and potions to enhance your fertility. Well, because if you and your spouse are not able to have a kid, it's clearly your fault. No one seems to consider that there may be something wrong with the liquid in his vault. Every time at a party, you have more than a glass of wine, some boy will think that you're open to 69, because alcohol works in different ways on both of us. When you resist our advances, we wonder why the fuss. We drink to wash off the stress, you drink as an invitation to rip off that dress. We create a weird paradox when you refuse us, you are no fun and a bore. Yet when you think us worthy and align with our advances, we proclaim to our friends later that you are a whore. Because one night stands are only for men, for women it's taboo to get out of their den. In the corporate world, it's the same. If you get promoted, obviously you slept with the boss. You were evidently a great player of the game. Your dress is what did the trick, and of course your lips with the gloss. Because why would it matter that you excelled in every department? You obviously paid a visit to his apartment. Yet it surprises me that we are called stronger. I have never come across a statement which could leave so much to ponder. In every department, you have proven yourself to be capable. Time and again, you've shown with example that the world is changeable. You've shown yourself to be financially independent, that you need no man to tie you with a pendant. You made the world hear your voice. You have made us see that you are no toys. You lead in every aspect. We are well aware of your abilities as a homemaker, but you lead in the corporate world as well with your trait of being a risk taker. Sometimes I wonder if you're just an evolved version of ourselves, exemplifying all traits and yet showcasing so much empathy. If anything, I think it's us men who deserve the sympathy. Sympathy being something which we shower our women with, but when it comes to rewarding them basis merit, that's still a myth. We owe you a promise and an apology to segregate on the basis of biology, and a promise to make the world a better place, for the world would be nothing without its women leading the race. So come and stake your rightful claim, speak out, speak loud, and we promise to lend a ear without subjecting you to any shame. While no apology will repair the damage already done, it may help the world come out of this dark period. So we promise to clear the way for you to rise like the sun. We owe you no sly smirks when you gulp your drink. We owe you no surprise when you make your point without a blink. We owe you respect when you are our boss. We owe you a mentality where you're there for more than just sauce. We owe you not being the trash can for our failure. We owe you a world where you're more than just our savior. We owe you a world where respect, love, and empathy are not just a luxury. We owe you a world where you're valued for more than just being motherly. We owe you not facing the fury of our temper. We owe you a world not judging on the basis of gender. We owe you acceptance of your sexual choices. We owe you a world where we no longer muffle your voices. We owe you a right to be educated, and we owe you a world where being a female is no longer ill-fated. Thank you.